certainly a time that Jeffrey will remember. We'll be reminiscing in just...
How did England fare on the first day of the fifth test? The highlights now on BBC Two with Richie Beno.
Hours after the new face of English cricket is unveiled at Lord's by the England and Wales Cricket Board, two more are introduced to Test cricket by the England selectors at Trent Bridge. 2-1 down in this Ashes series, England have dropped the marks, that's Butcher and Elam, to bring in the Hollyoaks, Ben and Adam, in the hope of levelling the series before the final test at the Oval. Well, whether the Surrey all-rounders can produce here the form they showed in the one-day internationals is quite a gamble. The pressure on Mike Atherton and the rest of his players is just as intense as ever. To prevent the Australians from winning the Ashes for the fifth consecutive time, England must win. And that could be asking a lot of a side without their best fast bowler, Darren Goff, who is out with a knee injury. Very sad for England that Goff can't play, but welcome to the highlights of the opening day's play of this fifth Test match between Australia and England at Trent Bridge. Not only do England have to win this match, but they also have to get around the question of the toss. Mark Taylor so far has won all four in this series. Simon Hughes is out in the centre now to see how he goes at his fifth attempt.
Mark, you've won the toss again. Aren't you going to let us have a chance?
Five in a row. So he's even changing corners on me, but I'm still winning the toss. But so I'm starting to get towards 50-50 now as a captain, so thanks to Mike, I'm turning it around.
Presumably you're going to bat first?
Going to bat, yeah, looks like a pretty good wicket. Probably one of the best wickets I've seen for the series so far.
You're not going to let us into this series, aren't you? Going for the jugular this game?
Oh, we're trying to win it, as we do every other Test match. But so there's five days of Test cricket to come, and the best side will win over 5 days.
What's the Australian secret?
Just to play good cricket. We try to come out and entertain the crowd and entertain ourselves by playing good cricket. That's what we're trying to do this game.
And you've had a settled team now for two Tests?
Yeah, I've got the same side again for this game, which is a good thing to have. We've been a bit lucky, we've got no injury worries at this stage, which is good news.
What's a good score, first innings?
Oh, as many as we can get. I don't know. As I said, the wicket looks very good. It looks like it'll play well, but you never know. We'll just have to wait and see what happens.
OK, good luck.
Thanks, Simon.
Michael, bad luck again. How are you going to cope with having to bowl first on this?
Well, we've got to win the game. We've got to bowl Australia out. So it doesn't matter whether we bowl first or second. That's what we've got to do.
And what's the team news?
We've left out Phil Tufnell, playing four seamers.
So is it a big blow that you haven't got Darren Goff for this game?
Well, it's disappointing for him because it's a big game. But in many ways it might turn out to our favour because it's an opportunity for the likes of Devon Malcolm, Andy Caddick, who've been left out the last game or two. They'll be keen to prove a point and take their opportunity.
How do you revive your flagging troops at this stage?
Well, everybody writes us off, but that's not a problem. If we play good cricket here, we've got a chance of winning the Test match. We've beaten Australia once so far this summer, we can do it again. And we're two matches away from winning the Ashes, so that's how we look at it.
But it really is make or break, isn't it, this Test?
Absolutely, but it's not a bad thing. People know we have to go out and win. That's what we'll be aiming to do.
And you're bringing in the two Hollyoaks as well, so another little problem for you, I suppose.
No problems. Good opportunities for them. I'm sure they'll go out and entertain the crowd.
Good luck.
Thank you.
Just confirmation of the two teams for today's game. England, with Darren Goff out, have brought in Caddick and Malcolm down the bottom of the list. And that reads Atherton, Stewart, Crawley at three. Hussain, Thorpe, the two Hollyoaks, Croft, Headley, Caddick and Malcolm. The Australians are unchanged from the side which won so well at Headingley. Confirmation also of the toss, that the Australians won the toss and will bat. And the umpires for today's match, David Shepherd and Cyril Mitchley. And the third umpire will be Alan Jones, and the match referee is the former West Indian Test player, Cammy Smith. Well, let's go out to the centre of the ground now and have a look at the pitch prepared by curator Steve Burks. Geoffrey Boycott awaits us.
Fifth Test match, super sunny day, and we have the best looking pitch of the whole series. You couldn't get a better looking pitch than this. It looks even, it looks flat, it just looks very good for batting. The texture of the pitch, well, I would say about medium pace. It looks even all over. It just looks very good for batting. I don't think there'll be any great pace in it. Once the new ball's gone after about 20 overs, obviously the new ball will go through a little bit. Nothing there for the spinners. It just looks to me that, quite frankly, the side batting first should make a lot of runs unless they bat badly or some bowler has to bowl out of his skin to get wickets on this. All in all, you should be queuing up to bat and make plenty of runs on it.
Well, Geoffrey Boycott thinks this is going to be a beauty. Might just be a little there for the pacemen early on. We join it now in the second over. Five runs on the board. Dean Headley is the man bowling and Matthew Elliott is taking strike.
That's nicely pushed through the offside by Matthew Elliott. Straight face of the bat. Robert Croft has been at cover now and mid-off, doing all the chasing this morning so far. Well, that's very, very close. Cyril Mitchley says not out, emphatically, but that was coming back into the left-hander. Have another look at it now. This is shaped beautifully from Dean Headley. It's pitched on, come back a bit. And it's all a question of height. Cyril Mitchley, I can only assume, has decided that was going over the top. That's beautifully bowled too, but that's gone through off the thigh this time. Dean Headley's spot on length here. The line is good. These are real testers.
Yes, he certainly terrorises the left-handers. Good delivery once again, just coming back into Matthew Elliott.
Well, he's got that one through the offside this time. Again off the back foot. This one he watched rather more closely. Well, the eyes have done it for him. The feet have done nothing, really. Well, that was perilously close. Played down apparently safely in defence by Matthew Elliott, but the momentum of the ball and the spin just carried it on. And it's bounced straight down and straight over.
Well, they should know by now that Elliott's pretty good on the short pitch delivery. It's the one where he loses control, where the ball's a bit up above head height, can't pull it down. He plays the pull stroke very well. That's good execution.
Bowled. Bowled.
That's landed in front of the man at slip. Malcolm is continuing his good form this morning.
Right in that area, you see, getting playing away from his body, maybe 6 inches outside off stump.
This will give us an idea of how fast the ball goes across the outfield. Yeah, it's good enough. It looks as though you'll get full support for the strokes you play out there. So it was turned that much, see. That's rather nice. A bit of fly fishing down the banks of the Trent. Nice sight, Trent Bridge. It's not absolutely packed at the moment, but people are still coming in through the turnstiles. Change in bowling. Andrew Carrick is coming on now. Take the place of Devon Malcolm. And that's the one that just held its own. Just pretty much went straight on.
Well, that was a better shout. That ball just coming back into the left-hander. That's what he's been trying to do at both left-handers. He didn't get the shout from the umpire. Look, that's a good shout. The time it hits him, pitched outside, when the ball hit him, I think it was fairly straightish. It may just have got outside Nobbet Justin, as we say, and the umpire's given him the benefit of the doubt.
Well, it sounded like two noises there, inside edge onto pad.
So a second over now for Ben Holyoake. Beautifully played, full face of the bat, and a real punch about that shot from Mark Taylor. Dean Headley. Rightly applauded, really good chase and recovery there.
Well, it was a good shot in the first place. And the good thing about Dean Headley is he's a very athletic individual. And he's just finished a spell bowling from the pavilion end, but he's still very keen to chase after that one and make an excellent stop down there in front of the pavilion.
Well, that's a good shot. Nicely played. No one down there, a third man. Real flexibility in the body there from Matthew Elliott. Just gave himself, made some room for himself. Well, that's a beautiful shot. You know, we've rarely seen Mark Taylor play the ball quite so straight as he is in this particular innings.
Well, it was a good strike of the ball, but the feet movement was nowhere. He really just stood still, and this has been Mark Taylor's problem throughout the series. He hasn't got his feet moving the way English viewers would have seen him moving his feet in the previous two series.
And that's four. And the 50 comes up. Beautifully and delicately played. Plenty of time to play it. Good shot by Matthew Elliott.
In this over, he's just tended to pitch the ball a little bit too short, as Ben Holyoake, to get the swing and the danger to the batsman. He's got to pitch it up a little bit more,
and he does, but he's beautifully played. It was a no ball, in fact. It's good chasing by the England's fielders. Devon Malcolm there races away down. Three runs to Matthew Elliott. Well, that was short. Not going to get away with too many of those in Test cricket. But then again, young Ben Holyoake may well feel a little nervous. He bowled a no ball. He's looking for some extra bounce. Got that short gully in, and all sorts of things pound through a young man's mind. Beautifully bowled. Just what Andy Carrick does best. Beautiful line just outside the off stump, and he gets an extra bounce which other bowlers don't get. He is tall, hits the ground hard. That might easily have flown to slip. And under the body this time. Michael Ashton's made some very good stops there at mid-off. He's quite close, in fact. He's just alongside the stumps. I just wonder if he need be that close.
Yep.
Beautifully played. Australia move on to 70 without loss. Been very steady progress this morning. 37 now to Matthew Elliott, 32 to Mark Taylor.
Yep.
That's going to be four runs. Just for a split second or so, it looked as though it might have cramped him for room. But there's no one down at the third man. He got on top of the ball again, guided away off the high part of the bat.
Yeah.
Nicely pushed. Could get two. No. Yes. Oh, there's a problem. Oh, dear. There was a canter for two, and then shall we or shan't we, and nearly a mishap. I don't think anybody was really calling there. It was almost a nice little jaunter, saunter down the pitch. Could be two that, shall we? Yeah, well, no, and sort of suddenly there was a bit of trouble. If the throw had been good and strong,
has gone for that and hit it very well indeed. Two men are still lurking out there, but there's no bounce in that. It was down the leg side, and that just split the two fielders. There's a gap of about 40 yards or so between them, only just above waist height. Roll his wrists on top of it. It's a very fine shot from Matthew Elliott. And now the elder brother, Adam Holyoake, also a debutant in this fifth test. Well, the ploy changed there slightly. Instead of short of wicket and short extra cover, two short extra covers so close together that either or both could have stopped this.
Yep. And a half century to Matthew Elliott. That fast outfield is going to test out the two fielders rushing towards it. Three to Elliott, 87 on the board. There's a nice start for him. And the outfield is quite fast. And it'll quicken up, I reckon, as the game goes on, depending on any rain that might fall. Yep. Two good strokes in this over, each of them to the boundary. Headley on both occasions getting the ball to come in the air, just that little bit of in-swing to the left-hander. Yeah, it's a good stroke from Taylor. Just made enough ground to get himself to the pitch of that.
Brings up the 100 for Australia.
Oh, shot. That's a beauty.
It's a nice way to bring up the 500 for the series, Matthew Elliott. And at a very good average of just over 80. He's a lovely driver, and he does it so easily.
I think that's missing leg stump. Looked as though it had darted back quite sharply.
Troubled Taylor occasionally. And this time, probably going over the top of the stumps.
That's for bolt. Good bit of bounce there from Dean Headley. Drew Taylor into the stroke.
Beat him for pace as well. Ball was through Taylor before the bat got down.
Nicely played and nicely placed. Looked a remarkable stop there. A charging run for Dean Headley up the deep mid-wicket boundary. Run up the rope. Got a bit tangled up with the rope. It's worth seeing again. And the umpire now has signalled four runs because the adjudication is that he was in contact with the rope while he was in contact with the ball. Now that's what I think Robert Croft is bowling best to the left-handed batsman, making them stretch a little way. I wouldn't say there's a great deal of rough outside the off stump, but it's interesting, and the odd one has turned. Oh, right through, and an appeal. And the finger goes up. That must have been an inside edge. It was a splendid bit of bowling. And Dean Headley really has deserved that. He's whipped a couple back into the left-hander right from the start. Let's take a look at this.
This one, I think, is a faint inside edge. It certainly didn't hit anything else, so if there was a noise at all, which we can't hear from sort of 100 yards away, then it was a faint edge. I don't think he's convinced that he nicked it.
Well, a lot of luck there for Bluett to get him off the mark. Very well bowled. The ball moving away to those three slips and a thick inside edge down to fine leg. Really had the batsman groping, and Greg Bluett there almost allowing for a little bit of swing. Let the bat drift away from his front pad. Well, that's a good shot. Just pulled down a little bit too short, and that's the best of Mark Taylor. He took his time, got right back on the stumps and picked his spot on the offside. And picked his spot on the scoreboard too, because he has 50.
Ah, there he is. Well, he's got away with it. But that's nice bowling. Yeah, you could say the batsman's got four runs. He hit it reasonably well, but not especially well.
That's really well bowled. And just the proper width to grab a top edge or an outside edge. Fine shot. Not badly bowled either. Well up and just moving away a little, but Greg Blewett's a fine player. And Dean Headley wants some protection out there. Well, beautifully played, beautifully played. Someone will say that it was there for it. It was very short, but still superbly accomplished, that pull shot from Mark Taylor. Mark Taylor moves on to 60.
Now he's going to have a chat to the umpire about the ball. Maybe the fact that Cyril Midgley has gone to speak to David Shepherd could suggest that the seam has split. That's usually one of the few reasons that the umpires will change the ball.
Well, they seem happy now. The batsmen haven't bothered. They don't care. Need to wait for umpire David Shepherd to see if that came off the pad. That's runs to Taylor, and it's four runs to Taylor. That takes Mark Taylor past the 6,000 run mark in Test cricket, 147 for one Australia. That's nicely placed. The outfield is fast all over and will quicken up as this game goes on. The bowling will need to be quite precise.
So Mark Taylor, the sixth Australian batsman to pass 6,000 runs in Test cricket.
It'll be strike bowling role for Malcolm, and he's on for his third spell. Taylor has got onto that pretty well, almost as though he might have said to himself, there's a chance this will be a loosener. This is a ball that's been replaced, and Simon Hughes can give us some more information on that.
Well, this is the ball that England have just rejected, and they're quite entitled to do that, of course. The seam has just split, you can see down here, and that's making the ball hard to grip. It's also making it lose its shape. There's not much shine on it either, and really this is just a bad ball. Alan Jones, the third umpire, has said that there's been quite a few bad balls in this particular batch, and the seam splitting there, plus the lack of shine, plus the loss of the shape, means that England are quite entitled to get a new one.
There was a wail of distress there from Andrew Carrick. It's raced away to the boundary. I assume that it must have gone slightly in the air. But it certainly went very fast off the bat.
That's well bowled by Devon Malcolm. Greg Blewett just a fraction slow in coming out to meet this. Oh. Nearly through. Greg Blewett very much looking for the drive. Oh, that's bowling. Mark Taylor is gone. Well, now that is a pleasant sight for Andy Carrick to see the back of Mark Taylor, to see the stump out of the ground. Australia's second wicket falling on 160. Really did beat Mark Taylor all ends up. He was a long, long way away from it with the bat. And he's heard enough. Doesn't need to look back. That's well bowled. Well, this ball very much swinging. It was changed just a few overs ago. The old ball coming apart at the seam, as Simon Hughes showed us, and now Andy Carrick using this replacement ball is getting this to go everywhere. Still swinging, but this time Mark Waters places it away off the mark for the boundary, guided just behind square on the offside. Well, well guided. Very nicely played by Greg Blewett. Didn't look a bad delivery at all from Andy Carrick. But again, giving an indication of how easy this pitch is. England operating without a third man. Anything that goes down there off the paceman is going to be four. More runs here. That's a better shot. More off the meat of the bat. And that one was wide from Devon Malcolm. Very nicely bowled. Well, he got the ball to swing before tee. It was a ball that was changed in that afternoon session. The first one gave up the ghost and was replaced by the umpires. Typical Mark War shot, just turning it off his legs. All ease and grace. And well done, John Crawley. Long chase for him. A dive at the end. But at the end, gains nothing, loses nothing. They've still run for.
I mean, that's beautifully bowled for a lively, fast medium, tall man, high action, right on a length. A
at almost perfection.
That's a very fine delivery.
You know, when you see an odd ball like this passing the bat, it's a beauty, isn't it? Pitches, holds its line, maybe just leaving him, bounces to the keeper.
And a good shot to follow. Such a good shot that third man, who's down there, can't get round to it in time. Four runs to Greg Blewitt. Oh, beautifully bowled. Well, it is frustrating. You can't blame him, Andy Carrick. He's produced another absolute beauty there. The away swinger. And this is a frustrating half hour as far as England are concerned. Again, a good delivery this time from Dean Headley, just cutting away. Good firm push. And two runs take Australia on to 201. Just for the loss of two wickets. Nicely flicked away, really does play that well. And no chance of John Crawley catching that one. Absolutely effortless shot by Mark Waugh.
There's certainly plenty of swing out there. Just a loosener from Ben Holyoake, very wide, and he's gone away. Oh, it looks like I might have jammed his, let's see, it's his second or third finger. That's well bowled. A little bit of extra life there. A bit of bounce surprise, Mark Waugh. Much more than a defensive shot, and yet it has beaten the fieldsman by a good 20 yards. Good stroke. Once again, Blewitt didn't give that a real thrash. It was a good calculated stroke. Quite a good 50 from Greg Blewitt. He's been beaten on the outside edge a few times. But he's overcome that and played some handsome strokes as well. Stewart, well done. Good catch. Ben Holyoake is going to be congratulated by everyone here, and so will Stewart be. Teammates at Surrey. That was a beautiful catch. Good anticipation. He decided to go for it. The ball was dropping a little. And Ben Holyoake's first victim. Steve Waugh comes out to join brother Mark.
Now that would have been extraordinary if Alex Stewart had managed to grab it. It was swinging down the leg side so far that Mark Waugh actually was a long way away from it with the bat, and that's a painful take for Alex Stewart. That swung as well. I'll tell you what, Adam Holyoake has got a real bag of tricks in his box there. He's got, everything happens. In, out, slower ball, you name it. He's got this one to come back in again, quite a long way. Yep. And from somewhere, Mark Waugh conjuring a boundary. That was just timing. Great shot. Well, that'll get Steve Waugh going nicely. Oh, just a fraction away. The inside edge, just for a moment, looked as though it might be coming back close to those stumps. Back onto the foot, I think. Well, that's good for a shot. Again, Dean Headley is the man who covers the ground so well. And turning a possible four into two for Devon. Very elegant, and four runs. Dean Headley again. He kept very much in work down there at long leg by the combination of Devon Malcolm and Mark Waugh. And the Australia 250 comes up.
Not a good bounce for Devon Malcolm, however. But there's nothing lost, really, by showing that gap, making the batsman play his drives with the hope of getting the catch at short mid-wicket.
It looks as if they might be going to take the new ball.
But there you are. That's one round of Steve Waugh. That's beautifully timed as well. Wonderfully timed. You see, the new ball is costing England runs now. And that's the 50 for Mark Waugh. And runs again. And this is the 50 partnership. Long run for Caddick. Three runs to Mark Waugh. So the new ball is really costing England runs now. It's a pity because a lot of good work's been done. Still, it can all be remedied by a late wicket. Well, that was lucky. Very lucky. But with this new ball, 13 runs have come off 9 deliveries with the new ball, but this was the nearest England have come to getting a wicket with it. Ooh, outside edge, and that might have gone to hand, but it was wide and flies away for 4 runs. Cracking shot. Well, Steve Waugh's almost waiting on the back foot for those. Terrific crack, square on the offside.
He'll always give these some stick.
That's very well bowled indeed. That was quick. It was much quicker than anything that's gone down over the last half hour. And I'm sure they're moving Devon Malcolm to get finer for this ball, which they had hoped Mark Waugh might have had a swing at, might have tried a hook. Well, I wouldn't have liked to be fielding a short gully. Applause right around the ground now for the 300 coming up. 301 for 3, the Australian score.
One more run added to take the final score for Australia along to 302 for 3. Elliott and Taylor got them away to a very good start. Matthew Elliott, 69, played well again. Mark Taylor was in good form before Caddick got a beauty through his defence, 76 for him, and blew it an even 50. Steve Waugh, 38, not out, and Mark Waugh, 60. Wasn't at his best today, but he saw it through to the end and was just running into form. Played some lovely strokes, but every so often there's a little stretch of strokes where he wasn't getting it off the middle of the bat, but tomorrow could be his day. 302 for three. Bowling figures for England. I thought they did well today. Headley, I thought, was outstanding. Very unlucky as well. 22 overs, four maidens, one for 72. Malcolm Nunn for 70, could have had better figures. Caddick, one for 54, certainly could have had better figures. Ben Holyoake, his first wicket in Test cricket. Robert Croft, 37 from 16. And Adam Holyoake, seven overs, no maiden, and Nunn for 24. Well, the Australian captain, Mark Taylor, should be pretty pleased with that. Here he is now talking with Simon Hughes.
Mark, you must have been delighted to win this particular toss, the fifth in a row.
Yeah, it's a lot easier than some of the other tosses I've won in this series so far, with the wickets being a little bit green. This one was obviously a bat-first toss, and I was delighted that we made good use of it today.
You certainly did that.
Yeah, I said, obviously 300 runs in a day's play is good going. All the batsmen got starts. It would have been nice for one of us to make 100, I suppose, but Mark and Steve Waugh at the crease, it would be nice to see them kick on and make 100 tomorrow.
You joined illustrious company yourself today.
Yeah, 6,000 runs, they tell me. That's obviously a milestone, but you don't play for milestones. You play for enjoyment. You get out of batting and play for the enjoyment of winning test matches. And hopefully my 6,000th run can help us go a long way to winning this test match.
You're very much in the ascendancy as a side over this series now. Can you put your finger on the turning point?
Oh, I think the turning point was probably the day after the first test match, as far as I was concerned. The guys got together and spoke about the fact we need to improve our cricket, and we've done that. Wasn't just talk, it's been turned into actions, and so far we've turned it round and turned it round well. But as I said, there's still 4 days to go on this test match, and I don't think it's over by any means. We've still got four tough days of test cricket left to play.
When you started out this morning, what was the objective? To perhaps put on an opening partnership for a change?
Yeah, well, I think Matthew and I put on 100 odd at Edgbaston in the second innings, but since then, you know, I've made a few low scores, so obviously it would have been good to get a good start like we did today, and then cash in, and that's probably the only thing we didn't do today. But if someone said to me 3 for 302 at stumps day one, I'd have taken it.
Well, Australian captain Mark Taylor was pleased with that, and now for their ideas on exactly what's gone on today and what might be going on for the rest of the game, is Geoffrey Boycott, and with him is Ian Chappell.
Well, it couldn't have worked out better for Australia. Lovely sunny day, flat pitch, batted well all day, and they're in the box seat now to retain the Ashes.
Yes, I think they are, and also to go on and win the game. But I think England can take some pride from their work in this match. It was very disciplined, the bowling. I thought at least they didn't bowl bad balls and let Australia hit easy runs. They made Australia work for the runs. So I think they could hold their head up after the first day.
Yes, I was pleased with the fact that they bowled some good balls. Didn't have much luck with the good balls, did they? Obviously, Australia were going to score runs because the pitch is good for batting. But all in all, I thought there were some good balls bowled. The body language was better.
Yeah.
They didn't let the game get away from them totally. So although it's been a good day for Australia, I don't think England could have done much more.
No, the problem now for England is that Australia have shown when they get a big first innings total, they're almost invincible. And it looks like a big first innings total.
And I think it's going to be a big, big batting day tomorrow for Australia.
Sounds as though it'll be a tough day for England's bowlers again tomorrow. This is a very good pitch, as was underlined there by Geoffrey Boycott and by Ian Chappell. Now tomorrow, the second day of this Cornhill Test match at Trent Bridge, BBC One will be on at 10:50 a.m. And from Trent Bridge now, we leave you with something that was a very, very good day for Australia's batsmen.